What's going on, guys? Today we're looking at the most recent trade in the NHL, the Avalanche sending Ryan Graves to the New Jersey Devils for a second-round pick and Mikhail Maltsev. I feel like this is a pretty good trade for the Avalanche. In my video yesterday, I actually thought, you know, they value him quite a bit. Would protect him over three forwards. Turns out they don't value him quite that much, but they do value him enough to not lose him for free. So I'll take a look at Graves here on the Avalanche. If you guys don't know, I'd say his coming out party was probably last season. He definitely stepped up, and it was actually his contract year. So he got this new contract, paying him $3 million. For 3 years. You can see he's a big defenseman. I think that's something Devils desperately need. They have a lot of, you know, younger, smaller guys. 25 years old, they're 6'5", 82 overall, their role top four defenseman, potential is also top four. Then listed as a defensive defenseman, I think that's fair. He also could be a two-way defenseman. Fourth round pick back in 2013, so took him a bit to develop, but definitely worth a fourth round pick. Was actually drafted by the New York Rangers. I did not know that. One thing too, if you guys look at his career stats here, again, last season, 26 points there in 69 games, so not too bad. That's why I think, you know, he could be a two-way guy. You can see the year before only had 5 and 26. This year he only had 15 points in 54 games, but I think that makes sense since last year I believe he got more time with Makar. After the Avalanche brought in Devin Toews, and with Samuel Girard playing even better, I think, you know, Graves is kind of just like the third best left-handed D-man. Again, you got Toews there, left side, 85 overall, that's pretty accurate. Actually, these are my ratings, they better be accurate. Girard there, 84 overall, again on the left side. So Graves would be the fourth best. Makar, of course, their number one defenseman. Eric Johnson, another right-hand guy. You can play second, third pair. You got Byram coming up, also left-handed. Timmins, I believe, is right-hand defenseman. So maybe they see him on the right side behind Makar and Johnson. And then left side, you're going to go Toews, Girard, and Byram, in which case, Avalanche D core still looks pretty good. So I do agree. I think, you know, this trade makes a lot more sense for the Avalanche. They're just protecting Ryan Graves. Now they can protect a few extra forwards. Probably be guys like Donskoy, Comfer, Tyson Joss, Valentin Shushkin. The fact that they can now trade Ryan Graves and get some assets back, I think is a good move. And they actually got a pretty good return considering the fact the Devils probably knew if they didn't make this trade, they were going to lose Graves for nothing. They got a second round pick in 2021. It's the Islanders pick, so it will be a late second rounder. So because of that, in game, it has a bit too much value because if it was the end of the season, the Islanders, you know, were picking 29th or whatever it was, the second round pick would definitely be less valuable. Unfortunately, the Devils' second round pick next year has like the exact same amount of value. So we'll just use the Islanders' second rounder there. And then as I mentioned, they're also getting a prospect back. In game, he's not really the best. As you're about to see, he's quite low here on the list. Mikhail Maltsev. So 22 years old, 75 overall. I think that rating's pretty fair. Like, he just made it to the NHL this season. AHL top 6 forward potential. I think now it's got to be at least medium bottom 6. I believe he played like 30 games in the NHL. Wasn't like a world beater or anything, but he's playing on the bottom 6. Looked, you know, fine. Now, the Devils roster this year, especially after Troy Mayer, Palmieri, Zajac, had a lot of AHL guys in it, but I think medium bomb 6 would be a bit more fair for him. Fourth round pick back in 2016. Was Graves also a fourth round pick in 2016? Exists, so that's kind of funny. He was drafted by the Devils, though. So, second rounder, Maltsev there for Graves. Fourth round pick 2013, my bad. Yeah, Graves was 25. Maltsev there still only 22, so he could turn into a bottom 6 forward for the Avalanche. Who knows if that's going to be the case. I feel like that's why they're also getting a second round pick. You can see the value is almost double the Devils' side. And they don't have Maltsev or the pick on the block, nor are they literally interested in Ryan Graves, which is kind of surprising to me. I should show you guys quickly. The Devils' defense, like, they would definitely need a guy like Graves. You got Severson, Subban, who's 31, making 9 mil. Butcher, Murray, they're about to lose. Ty Smith's a good young defenseman. After that, not a lot. I think I actually had them protecting Siegenthaler as their third D-man, so easily they can protect Ryan Graves after making this trade. I'm pretty sure it's going to be a no from the Devils. And yeah, it is trade rejected, so I'll force this through just to kind of show you guys what the Avalanche roster will look like without Graves. So after trading away Ryan Graves, here's an update look at the Avalanche roster. I'm just kind of doing my best guess of what their forward group will look like next year. I believe Landeskog will be back as the captain. I know there's a lot of rumors right now that they're really far off in contract talks. Landeskog wants 9 to 10, and the Avalanche are offering 5 to 6, so literally half. I feel like they'll probably come to an agreement somewhere around 7 by 7. So MacKinnon, Rantanen, of course, still there. Donskoy, Kadri, Burakovsky, Newhook, Comfort, Jost, and Shushkin, Soderberg, and Calvert. Now, like I was mentioning, I think one of Comfort, Jost, Donskoy, and Shushkin will be taken by Seattle. Who that's going to be, though, I don't know. Now, I actually have Newhook in place of Sod. I feel like Sod's definitely going to test free agency. There's so many teams with a ton of cap space. He's going to get some money. Martin Kaut, I guess, could come in for whoever gets taken by Seattle. Patrick Nemec there, they could bring back, but I really don't think they need to. Like I mentioned, this is their defense without Ryan Graves. Toews, Makar, Johnson, Girard, Byram, and Timmins. I think that's a pretty solid D-core. And, of course, they got a couple of cheap guys in Byram and Timmins who are still young. So, Avalanche, to me, still look like a really good Stanley Cup contender for next year. Now we'll try the trade from the Devils' perspective. So like I was saying, guys, we're not going to try the trade from the Devils' perspective. Again, you can see it's about double on our side. The Avalanche do not have Graves on the block, nor are they interested in our second or Maltsev. I mean, they're in win-now mode, so that does make sense. This is definitely like an expansion trade move. We'll see what they say to this. Trades rejected. I thought that might happen, even though the value's on our side. With Graves on the block, them not liking our stuff. Yeah, that can happen. So I mean, the fact both sides rejected, that's another way to see that it is a pretty fair trade. If both sides reject or both sides accept, usually it's pretty fair. It's when, you know, only one side says yes, where we kind of have a clear winner. So I kind of agree with this. I think it's a pretty fair trade from the Avalanche perspective. Again, I get it. You still have a good decor without Graves. You're able to protect three forwards now in his place, and you get back a second round pick and a prospect, which is a pretty good return. For the Devils, you need defense. You need kind of a team. Like, they have a lot of holes to fill, in my opinion. And Graves definitely slots in their top 4D. Still relatively young at 25. Maltsev, you have a lot of prospects better than. And you can definitely afford to give up the second round pick, seeing as you have two first rounders this year. Ideally, you only have to go up, say, like a third and a seventh or something instead of the second. But again, I think the Devils have enough picks. It's worth it for them. So next year, guys, is my best guess what the Devils' lines might look like next year after the trade. So I've got Zacha, Hischier, and Bratt as the first line. Zach had a pretty solid season this year, 35 points, so maybe they give him a chance on that top line. And then have Miles Wood on the second line with Jack Hughes and Alexander Holt. I feel like hopefully Holtz makes a team next year for the Devils, and if he does, you gotta play with Hughes, probably your best playmaker on the team with potentially the best sniper you're gonna have in Holtz. Should be a deadly duo, and I think Wood can be your guy that kind of like gets in the corners, kind of does the dirty work for that line. Sharangovic, McLeod, Kukkonen on the third line, and then Janssen, Merkley, and Boqvist on the fourth line. When I was looking at the Devils expansion protection list, I feel like Seattle will probably take either Nick Merkley or PK Subban. The thing, of course, with Subban is if the Devils lose him, they're actually going to be way below the cap, which I think I mentioned before. So the Devils should be pretty active in free agency, and if not, they should be very active in taking other teams' bad contracts for a big price, like, you know, get that Patrick Marleau for a first round pick or things like that. Really help them with that rebuild. So I have Subban still on the defensive roster. You can see Graves, Severson top pair, Subban, Butcher second, Siegenthaler-Smith on the bottom pair. I've actually got Ryan Murray scratched, as I believe he probably is going to test free agency. He actually stayed healthy for most of this year for the first time in a while. So I feel like teams will, you know, hope that he's going to stay healthy. And because so many teams have cap space this year, I'm thinking someone's going to give him a payday. It could be the Devils, but I'm assuming it's not. You know, their defense still didn't look too bad for them. It's definitely just offense. Like, it's not terrible. There's some names there, but they got to bring in some more, like, legit forwards, in my opinion. Basically just guys with more experience. Next, I'll give you guys a look at Ryan Graves on the Devils. I'm honestly not sure what his game face even looks like here, how accurate it is. Not the most accurate, but also not the worst I've ever seen. So there you go, Ryan Graves as a Devil first look. That's me, guys, for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a thumbs up. Let me know in the comment section which team you think won the trade. Again, I think it was pretty even. And as always, guys, if you haven't subscribed yet, hit the sub button. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.